Wells was very well represented at St Andrew's Church in Soho, Cambridgeshire, on Monday. But all would be glad that he's being celebrated today at St Phillips, at the heart of the community, Sherwood, that he loved, and the church so full of so many of his friends. Because Bob had great gifts for serving his community and for friendship. He was immensely proud to serve for over 10 years as the councillor for this ward. So dedicated was Bob to everything here in Sherwood that sometimes, rather eccentrically, he would sign emails to me as Sherbob. And all of the political colleagues here know that Sherwood has always been a marginal seat and you win it through hard work, both in the campaigns and hard work for residents. Now that suited Bob to a T. He won his first seat at a by-election on the 20th of December 2010, amid snow and ice and almost the darkest, longest night of the year. And he knocked on every door in the ward, twice. He kept it up, and he would be out rain or shine talking to people wherever they were, at the TN2 Centre, here at St Phillips, the coffee mornings, or what became his mobile surgery, the 277 bus. Now, some people talk about the opinion of a man who was a warm, kind, and generous friend. Whenever I made a meter appearance, whether that was at 6:10 in the morning on the Today programme on Radio 4, or after 11 o'clock at night on Newsnight, within seconds of coming off the air, I would get a positive and encouraging text from Bob. Indeed, such was the dependability of his immediate good wishes that I sometimes wondered if he was the agent of the security services with some special monitoring to detect whenever I was on the broadcast airwaves. A reflection of the character of the man. It wasn't always easy for Bob, but he should be proud of what he achieved. And we, his Tunbridge Wells family, proud to have him as one of our own.